It's a big panel tonight on the news. It's a big subject. We're going to open up the debate. I'm going to first throw a few couple of straight questions to this man, Bindu Dara Singh, who's live with us tonight. Then we'll open it up for and against. But let me introduce everyone. Atul Vasan, still against the ban. Suman C. Raman will join us. He's with us now. Against the ban. Sanjay Hegde, still against the ban. He's an advocate in the Supreme Court. Bimal Soni, Deputy President of the Rajasthan Cricket Association, against the ban. These are all those who support Srinivasan. Directly, indirectly, voluntarily, involuntarily, with or without motive. For the ban today, Shishir Hatangani keeps his position. Kishore Bimani keeps his position. Himanshu Chaturvedi is an aggressive debater of the Lok Diksha Sports Law Initiative, keeps his position. And welcome to the panel, Charu Sharma, who emerges after a long time on the news. Good to see you, Charu. Let's debate. And my first question is to the very misguided man called Bindu Dara Singh. Now, Mr. Bindu Dara Singh, just let's start with a confession. How long were you and Gurunath Maiyappan doing this?
You have to understand one thing. First of all, let me just ask you one thing, that you've called me on the show at last after 1.5 years of saying things like I'm with Daoud, I'm with this, that. So is there any apology, or Supreme Court also has no value now?
Well, I think you do illegal things, and you know, you should be the one answering the questions.
No, I want to know. You guys keep on saying something.
No, that first of all, there's no you guys out here. You know, Mr. You see, Mr. Bindu Dara Singh, one second. Let's get one thing very clear tonight. But one thing very clear. I ask the questions, you answer. Okay?
I want to answer. 1.5 years, I've been.
So, Mr. Bindu Dara Singh, answer some questions. Answer some questions. I know you're a good actor, but answer some questions.
I've never said. I don't act. I've never said you. I'm a B-grade actor on an A-grade show. So I just want to tell you one thing. I've never ever lied.
I didn't call you B-grade. I didn't call myself A-grade. I'm asking you a question. My first question is, Mr. Bindu Dara Singh, how long were you and Gurunath Maiyappan doing this? How long were you doing this illegal act of betting?
Listen to me. The main thing is that everything is in the court.
How long were you doing it?
They've said we've... Maybe this year, the last year that was there. I know him since 3 years.
So 3 years.
Never bet, but I've been betting.
No. How long were you and he partners in betting?
No, he's not a partner of mine in betting. He just felt like something. He just like.
What do you mean felt like? No, come on, give me the details. What? No. One second, Mr. Bindu Dara Singh. How long was it going on between you and Gurunath Maiyappan? Whether you were partners or not, I'm not saying you signed a legal contract. How long were you engaged in this nefarious act of betting?
You have to understand that this everything I've spoken to the court. The court has given us clean chit. Why are you?
But how long were you betting?
The court and keeping on saying this.
What? Why are you nervous? Why don't you tell me how long were you betting?
No, I'm telling you, we've not even exchanged one single penny. So the betting is.
I'm not saying. One second.
Maybe 3-4 months.
3-4 months. Okay. So you were okay. Thank you for the confession. I'm now going to question number 2. You shouldn't have wasted so much time in coming to that answer. Now I find it completely amazing. First of all, you bet. Secondly, you bet with a team official who is also the son-in-law of the BCCI chief. One second. Now, you're not Alice in Wonderland, Mr. Bindu Dara Singh. You know exactly what's going on. You admit to having bet. And I find it amazing that when you were talking to my reporter earlier today, you were so blasé about it. You said there's nothing wrong in betting.
Why should I lie? There's nothing to lie.
You break the rules. The least you can say is sorry.
What? Which rules?
You broke the IPL rules.
Half crore Indians bet.
You were. Don't compare. This is not about Indians betting. This is not about Indian betting. Again, you are wrong. No, it's not. I'll tell you why. Horse racing. You use the example of horse racing. Betting at a horse race. One second. Betting at a horse race is legal in India. You know that.
Absolutely.
Right. It's not legal in cricket. It's not legal in cricket.
Yes.
You talked about a card game of Rummy or Paplu. That's legal. Betting in IPL is not legal. So simple. Don't you understand it?
Why don't you just shut the live telecast? Why don't you have a half an hour delayed telecast so all this ends?
Makes no sense. My point is, you were not indulging in friendly bets with friends. You were betting with Gurunath Maiyappan, who is a team official. A team official. Secondly, is the son-in-law of the BCCI chief. Don't you get it?
And you have to understand that his BCCI chief has been given a clean chit. Gurunath, whatever he has done, whatever the BCCI, whatever the Supreme Court...
Did Gurunath share any information with you that he was privy to by virtue of being a team official?
Okay, now listen.
Did he share any insider information with you?
Now explain to me. I'm telling you that we've lost. What insider information are you talking about?
I am asking you, did he share any information with you that he was privy to by virtue of being a team official? Did he share any insider information with you?
This inside information business, I really want all these people on the panel to just answer. There's a place where you can go half an hour.
One second. You have indulged in a criminal offense and you have indulged in something which is a criminal offense in the country. You can't have
this.
This
is a bailable offense. And I would ready to
bailable offense. Bailable offense. Why did you say IPL is 100% fixed?
Don't put words in my mouth.
I don't put words in your mouth. That is exactly what you were reported in a ZTV sting operation reported by the Indian Express. You want me to quote you?
You have to understand. No, I will tell you one thing, Mr. Arnab. I want to know that why out of the whole 1.5 crore Indians, only I have been phone tapped and caught. Why? To get to Mr. Srinivasan. So if that's not work, now I'm sorry.
Keep the motives aside. The act of the crime happened or didn't happen. You admit to the crime or not? Now I need to move on.
Crime.
Tell me quickly.
You
admit to the crime.
You have to understand, I have nothing to do with these people.
Do you admit to
I
the
have
crime?
Nothing to do with Mr. Ramesh Vyas or Mumbai. There's no crime. I've not done any crime. It's my money. I burn it. I throw it. I give it to the beggars. I give it to any bookie. I don't care.
I thought, this is really shameless. I thought you'd at least say sorry.
I am shameless.
Okay, you are shameless. Fine.
I'm sorry.
Okay, now stay
sorry
on to the debate, Bindu Dara Singh. Stay on. I mean, this is exactly the problem, you see. Mr. Bindu
here.
Dara Singh,
here.
People like you believe
here,
we can
brother.
Get away with it. You know, you think this is all one big game, one gigantic game. You think this is a B-grade movie, but it is cricket. One second, a question being asked to you. Himanshu Chaturvedi, let me get you into the debate. Absolutely no remorse. Now we'll open up the debate. The IPL chief is caught running an IPL bookie ring. It's people like Bindu Dara Singh who feel almost encouraged by the lack of action taken so far. What would you say to Bindu Dara Singh? Himanshu Chaturvedi ji, aap kuch kehna chahenge? Please go ahead.
Yeah, Bindu, directly I have this report of ICC anti-corruption. Do you know what they talk about you? That you have been association with Gurunath Mayappan dealing. Even before the sixth session of IPL. Listen to me now. And what are they talking about? Your riding, your horse betting. He says you were betting on horses, used to pay money to caretakers of top contender horses, get them fed the horses a day before the race, so they fell and they earned huge money by betting on the horses. This is what is written about you, and I have a copy of this with me. This is what you've been doing.
Please,
this
you
is
get that copy? Yeah.
What he's talking about is something bigger than just innocuous betting.
You can say anything now. I've understood that highly placed forces can say anything.
No, why would you make friends? Bindu Dara Singh, tell me, why would you make friends with Gurunath Mayappan? Everyone wants to know one question. You sit in Mumbai, you're an actor. What do you have in common with Gurunath Mayappan?
I'll explain to you.
Please explain to me. One second, Himanshu is asking another question. Himanshu.
You have a direct connection with Mukesh Gupta, who's the bookie. Now this is all there. And you were found. Come again.
Hello.
Mukesh Gupta, well-known bookie.
Listen to me. The truth.
He's reading from a report, Bindu Dara Singh.
Again.
You have to understand. Where is that?
That during 2009,
have they spoken to me?
Bindu Dara Singh
spoken to me or questioned me?
He's reading from a report, Bindu Dara Singh. First of all, don't get worked up. He's reading from a report.
But I don't know about the report.
The official said that I'm talking of an ACSU officer of the ICC who said during 2000 match fixing scandal also Bindu's name had cropped up. So it is not new that you come.
But have they ever questioned me or asked me?
Gurunath Mayappan, you've been involved in betting since 2000. And you know, you've been
has anybody ever
horses. You have not even spared animals. Forget about human beings. You did not even poor animals.
Please tell me, has anybody ever questioned me in 2000?
So what? So what?
But this is the report.
So what?
I have it.
They can write whatever they want.
So what? That's your background.
But have
not written by me.
So what? Is it the problem they haven't questioned you? Bindu Dara Singh, this is ridiculous. Why would they question? No, one second. You say I got away for so long.
Not mine.
He says I got away for so long, so there's no argument to be made.
But you didn't do it.
The Mudgal people came to me and told me, were you ever questioned in 2005 CBI? And I said, nobody ever asked me even a one plain question. So they were shocked.
No,
they
but what? So are we. We are also shocked that you weren't.
Letters,
that doesn't mean that you can now turn around and say, I am the victim.
There's a lawyer.
Now.
There's a lawyer, Mr. Mehmood Abidi, who keeps writing letters.
All right, we'll open up the debate. Open up the debate. At stake tonight, one second, Bindu Dara Singh. At stake tonight is our faith in cricket. Right? Kishore Bimani?
Yes.
That's 1 minute.
I love the game.
You don't love the game at all. You betrayed the game and you betrayed people. One second, please.
How can you
please,
say that?
One
How
second. At stake tonight is, you know, I feel Kishore Bimani, after today, it's not about Sundaraman being sacked. It's not about whether Srinivasan will or will not get away. It's not about only whether Raj Kundra has to answer questions. It's about the whole damn game. I mean, there is no faith left. Who has any faith in the IPL anymore after this? Even if you sack the IPL chief, Kishore Bimani, and people like Bindu Dara Singh seem to be so, you know, blasé about it, almost as if they got away. They want to present themselves as victims. Kishore Bimani.
Arnab, if we can bring the temperatures down a little, let's return to rationality. The questions you are asking Bindu Dara Singh have to do with the fact of inside knowledge. If today Gurunath Maiyappan, who has been a principal owner of the team, who sits in the dugout, who works at the nets with the team, who's in the dressing room, now if he has exchanged information with Bindu Dara Singh, it is totally culpable. What we want to know is, did Mr. Dara Singh bet on matches based on his information gleaned from Mr. Gurunath Maiyappan, which would be a betrayal of faith, which would be inside information being traded, and which would be the most culpable of all.
How do we know?
I think talking about...
No, but how do we know? We can't... I'm saying this to Bindu Dara Singh. Bindu Dara Singh cannot be trusted.
No.
Bindu Dara Singh cannot be trusted. After what he has done, I can't take his word for it.
The Mudgal committee has told us that you've lost on the match. So now, is that enough?
Certainly not. The Mudgal committee has told us, and even Suman C. Raman will accept it tonight, the Mudgal committee has told us that the man at the top of the IPL was a corrupt man. So people like Suman C. Raman, who are building moats around, fortresses around that person, trying to defend Sundar Raman, will have to acknowledge tonight they were wrong.
Arnab, I'm sorry. I vehemently object to that. I have never said a word in defense of Mr. Sundar Raman. I hold no brief.
You spoke in defense of Mr. Sundar Raman last Friday.
No. We were talking about Mr. Srinivasan and not Sundar Raman. Arnab, you're changing the gear.
The same system. What is Sundar Raman from a different system?
Please, you can play back your tape.
Is Sundar Raman from a different system?
I have never spoken a word.
Is Sundar Raman from a different system? And where's the propriety as far as Srinivasan is concerned? Why are you defending Srinivasan? Why are you defending Srinivasan?
No, because I said that there is no evidence as yet produced against him. And that's exactly what...
His son-in-law has been found guilty of betting. How can he get away?
The Mudgal committee has not said a word saying that he has been linked to his son-in-law in terms of having got the...
Sir, did he act? I think you are not aware of the facts now. One second. I'll quote the report. I'll quote the report. Now, you know the report. You have page number 26 with you. You want to have a look at it? Mr. Raman, you want to have a look at it? Should I read it for everyone?
I have read the report.
So what does page number 26 say? This individual, this individual, that is Mr. Srinivasan, along with four other BCCI officials, was aware of the violation of the player's code of conduct by individual 3. Who is individual 3?
But that is an act of omission. It is the same as saying that the man picked...
Omission. It also goes on to say no action was taken against individual 3 by any of the aforesaid officials who were aware of the infraction.
So absolutely, that's the same thing, that the same accusation.
So Srinivasan knew but did nothing, right?
Right.
So why did he do nothing?
That's exact. We need first Arnab.
Why did he do nothing?
Individual 3.
Why did he do nothing? What if I argue tomorrow? What if I argue tomorrow that Srinivasan did nothing, and the argument can be made, Mr. Sanjay Hegde, that Srinivasan did nothing because he was aware that he's got a chink in his own armor in the form of his son-in-law, who's a punter. And half a bookie himself.
Dr. Raman, can I tell you something?
No, no, what's it?
Arnab, just... Yeah, yeah, go ahead, Himanshu.
Sanjay Hegde, please. Sanjay Hegde, go ahead. Yes, Sanjay. No, what's it? I want to see what argument Sanjay Hegde puts forward.
The report on Srinivasan says the individual is not involved with match-fixing activity. It also says the individual was not found involved in scuttling the investigations into match
scuttling
fixing.
The pro. Exactly.
The individual was aware of a violation of the player's code of conduct by individual 3, but no action was taken.
Why was no action taken?
There are several reasons why you don't take action against a player. You can leave it to the team. Is it the job of the team owner to take an action or the head of the BCCI? Whoever is the relevant person.
That's a really silly argument.
What he has done.
It's a really silly argument.
Explanation by the 24.
That's a really silly argument.
That is precisely why the Supreme Court has given them time.
That's a really silly argument. That why should the BCCI chief know?
There are arguments which work with judges, but there won't be arguments which will shut you up.
The idea, Mr. Sanjay Hegde, is not to shut me up. The idea is to present a strong counter argument. So my point to you is, my point to you is tonight, I have two questions for you, Mr. Hegde, and don't get personal with me. Answer me on fact.
I hold no brief for Mr. Srinivasan. My only role was.
Are you sure?
My only interest.
Are you sure you hold no brief for Mr. Srinivasan?
I have no brief for Mr. Srinivasan. 100%. I wish I did, but that's a different thing.
Is that why you are taking his side? Because you wish you did?
I don't hold a brief for anyone, and I'm on your channel saying, just switch off the game. Just switch off the game. I take my personal decisions. My personal decision is I don't watch.
Okay.
Switch off the game.
Charu Sharma.
Watch, I say, okay.
Charu Sharma or Shishir Hatangadi. Charu Sharma, Shishir Hatangadi.
Let's have it as a.
No, no. Charu Sharma and Shishir Hatangadi today, Sanjay Hegde and Suman C. Raman appear to be a little bit on the back foot. Because last week when they came on the debate, they were both saying absolutely nobody has done anything wrong. You will all be proven wrong. IPL is fantastic and let it continue.
Arnav. Mr. Raman,
the question you need to ask yourself is
IPL, let it continue.
The question you need to ask yourself is
exactly what we said. IPL continue, but not Mr. Srinivasan. Not Mr. Srinivasan, let the IPL continue.
Himanshu,
nobody
Himanshu
has problem with
IPL.
Mr. Srinivasan.
That we've got to get this man at all costs.
We have Himanshu on our side this time.
Why the Rajasthan police dropped the investigation into Rajkundra, why the Mumbai police didn't follow up on any of the other numbers that they found, but we've got to fix this guy, right?
I'm sorry, Mr. Himanshu. Sumant Raman. I'm sorry,
I'm not defending him. If a wrong is done by the police, does not make Mr. Srinivasan right.
Charu Sharma, Shishir Hatangadi, come into the debate, please. Charu Sharma, Shishir Hatangadi, I say tonight, ban RSK, ban CSK, ban Rajasthan Royals. At the very least, what do you think, Shishir? Ban them at the very least.
Well, I'll just start with saying that, you know, today's a bad day for the name Ramans. You know, everybody's having a bad day, so we understand that. Secondly, I mean, if you flouted the rules as an owner, you've got to go. I mean, come on.
Of course.
You can have various forms of punishment for every team. But the fact is, if the owners have flouted rules, you've got to go. I mean, let's not get emotional about this. Secondly, if the president and the chairman or the president of the BCCI was aware and was looking the other way, he has to have an answer for that. I mean, we're not personally against him, but if he knew what was happening, and only Mr. Sundar Raman, the other Sundar Raman, can testify that was he passing on information to the administrators that this is what is wrong with the BCCI, or what is happening in the IPL. If he was, and they weren't reacting, then somebody has to be answerable. So I think Mr. Sundar Raman will be able to tell us what went wrong, really, because at the moment, he won't find too many friends or people supporting him. You know, his time looks like it's running out.
Okay, my question tonight is, should you sack the IPL chief, one, but two also, will you watch IPL after what has happened? Charu Sharma, banning Rajasthan Royals, banning CSK is going to need to be the first of the few steps of corrective action that need to be taken. Which side are you on this, Charu?
Well, yeah, I mean, you know, obviously there's a case for sacking these two teams by the rules and of the franchisee agreement that the board itself or the IPL has drawn up with the franchises. However, if we were just to rewind a bit, there are three players or even more who have been dealt with very severely by this very board and the IPL committee for serious grave infringement. However, the teams that they belong to were still not terminated. So already we have a case where action has been taken against far graver charges of spot fixing rather than just betting, although of course betting by team members or the management of a team also is potentially very hazardous because it could lead to vested interest. So all this obviously points to violation of this very famous clause 11.3C or 3 or whatever it is. And the board itself has made a rule that if the game's reputation is brought down, then teams, the contract can be terminated. We've seen that although players have been sacked, the teams have not been terminated. Players belonging to the teams that you talk about. Now there's management which is also guilty of at least betting, which is illegal. But fine, the government may take no action on what is a very slight crime. But the board itself needs to prove that the laws that they've made for IPL teams are good enough to be taken action on. It hasn't been done so far, but it's a very tricky situation for the board. Now, of course, this conflict of interest becomes very interesting because will the chief sack his own team because of his own law?
Well, he should. He has to. He has no choice. Exactly. It's no, one second. No. Atul Vasan, one second. Atul Vasan, what action should be taken against Mahinder Singh Dhoni?
Why? What has he done?
Well, he called also Gurunath Maiyappan a cricket enthusiast, didn't he?
Well, we don't know exactly what he said. I don't know.
Didn't he say Gurunath Maiyappan is a cricket enthusiast? Wasn't that widely reported?
You know, but I would, I will only.
No, one second. Why?
Whatever has happened is now.
You don't want to talk about these things. Why?
You've been saying. I want to say that the faith. Yes. So he was, at that point, we didn't know that this was going to blow up in everybody's face. And everybody was falling in line. I would give him that kind of leniency for a little bit for now.
But what leniency?
Point is that everybody's going to lose the faith. So I'll tell you, if he lost faith, then there were half a dozen MPs in prison. There were a few doctors who were selling body parts in prison. There are legislatures. They are top corporate head
of
prison. If I had to lose faith, I would just curl up in the bed and sleep. I still go out and I want the rotten people to be taken to task and the things carry on. Otherwise, we lose faith in everything. Why should
did
I
you actually say that?
You people have done wrong.
Did I actually hear you say that?
Yes, of course.
Or am I need to pinch myself to believe that Atul Vasan, you made that argument?
Why? So
you actually say that politicians are corrupt? There are low-level politicians.
Yes.
Let there be some low-level cricketers as well. Why do you complain?
No. So we should lose faith in all governors in India.
I'm saying we lose faith in cricket. We lose faith in cricket.
Moves on.
I'm saying we lose faith in cricket, Mr. Atul Vasan.
So let's not burn the whole system. Let's not burn the whole system for a few rotten apples.
Okay,
take them aside, penalize them.
Okay, no, one second. What is left of the system? Bimal Soni.
That's not right, is it?
Bimal Soni. Bimal Soni, what is left for the...
99% of the system is still intact.
What is left of the system?
99% of the system is still intact.
Okay, one second.
So for 1%, you want to stop everything?
No, I'm saying what is left of the system. The chief operating officer of IPL is half a bookie. He's in touch with bookies. He calls bookies 7-8 times in a season. Right?
What are you doing?
He does not confront Gurunath Maiyappan. He does not confront Raj Kuntra. Raj Kuntra breaks all kinds of codes, is in touch with bookies. Raj Kuntra goes around hunting for players he can fix. So, Bimal Soni, what is left of the system? Rajasthan Royals is in tatters. Yeah. CSK is doing questionable stuff. The CEO of the IPL is a corrupt man.
Let me answer, Arnab.
Yeah, well done. Yeah.
Arnab, let me answer your questions. We are going beyond our purview today.
Why?
I think what we have to get into is that CSK and Rajasthan Royals owners or team principals or have done a fault, okay? And according to the law of IPL 11.3, the team should be considered to be banned if they are proved right. That's one point.
No, so and one second. Let me hold you there. I have a counter question
first
for you.
By the IPL Governing Council.
I have a counter question for you. My question is, tell me the rule.
Let me look at the rule book and tell me
what happens when the IPL boss is in touch with bookies. What does the rule say on that?
Arnab,
what happens when the boss of the IPL is half a bookie? What happens then?
Must be banned.
He should be.
Should be. He will be.
Okay, Arnab, I am giving you that answer.
Can be suspended.
Yeah.
All right. It doesn't say must be.
Yes, Bimal Soni. Yes, Bimal Soni. Give me the answer.
Listen. Let me answer this. First of all, if it has been mentioned and if Supreme Court has said this about, then he should be immediately sacked or suspended and given an option to answer whether he is right or wrong. But if the mistake has been committed, he should be sacked immediately. Number one.
Okay.
Number two, we are looking at CSK and Rajasthan Royal owners who have been indicted by this report. Let Supreme Court give its judgment on 24th. An action should be immediately taken. But the other team members, the reflection of IPL, rotten eggs can be anywhere. But IPL cannot close. I mean,
why?
The game of cricket
why?
Won't go to disrepute.
Why will India come to a halt? India come to a halt if IPL closes down? Will people come out on the streets saying we want IPL? We want the IPL. Let there be as much corruption. We want IPL.
Went to prison.
Let there be bookies fixing. Let IPL officials do all that they want to. But you're saying people will come out on the streets saying we want the game to continue, even if it's completely corrupt. And to what level of corruption, Mr. Bimal Soni, are you willing to accept? Both Gurunath Maiyappan and Raj Kundra have been indicted of betting officially.
People like
Bindu Dara Singh are today feeling
so
strengthened. They feel they have done nothing wrong. They are comparing cricket to a game of cards. This is what Bindu Dara Singh is comparing cricket to going to the races. This is what you've reduced the game to, Mr. Soni. People like you.
Paint this out to be the Armageddon.
Please,
it would have been Armageddon if few players.
Please don't take the debate towards Bindu.
Well, it is. Well, it is. It is. It is. It is because Atul. Because Atul, people like you. Atul, people like you have been. You have been constantly trying to sort of ensure that there is no big time impact on IPL. What is more important for you, Atul Vasan? The IPL or cricket as a game?
Yeah, it's important for me.
What is him? Have you not played first-class cricket? Don't you feel strongly about it?
Because you are trying to just finish everything just for the fault of few people. That's wrong.
I am saying today this report.
They hear and they scrap the system.
I am saying Atul.
Who gains? Tell me. Atul. Only for fault of few people. Please tell me this.
Atul Vasan.
One question.
Atul Vasan, I have one question.
Please tell me. Are you for making thousands of people suffer because of fault of three people? Please tell me this.
Yeah. So Mr. Those thousands of people, those millions of people are feeling so cheated, Atul Vasan. They are feeling so cheated, Atul, that if I open up the phone lines, I want a cricketer like you. You played the game, but you are so deeply entrenched in the system today, Atul. You are so deeply entrenched in the system that you're willing to be blind to a fault on what's happening. Yes, Sumant Sriraman. Sumant Sriraman. Okay, go ahead. Sumant
Sriraman.
Sumant Sriraman.
You're making this point that the nation has been cheated and millions of cricket fans have been cheated. When is the nation cheated? When you prove that any player has underperformed deliberately, when any team has underperformed deliberately, that is when the cricket fan can stand, turn around and say, you guys cheated me because I came expecting a fair game and you...
Yes, I agree with that.
Okay. One sec. First of all, Sumant Sriraman. No, first of all, Sumant Sriraman. Himanshu Chaturvedi wants to take you on. Himanshu Chaturvedi, please. Himanshu Chaturvedi. Mr. Chaturvedi. Yes, Mr. Chaturvedi. Mr. Chaturvedi. The debate is open now. Mr. Chaturvedi, we are going to open up the phone lines and take a few questions after 10 minutes. Yes. Mr. Chaturvedi.
Can I just make a statement quickly? Come on.